Good morning and welcome, and most of all, happy St. George's Day.
Yay.
Now, we English love an excuse, any excuse for a bit of a party, and so we're getting ready and decorating for St. George's Day. You'll see the crosses of St. George on our dresser here. Now, as it's coming up to breakfast time, never too early to start a party, we're going to have a look at your cookware, well, your sort of table tools, you know, your plates and dishes and cups and whatever, all through history. So I'm going to start by going right back to prehistory. Well, the earliest cup was your cupped hands,
yeah.
You see, and you can pick water up, and savages do that.
Yes.
But we're not savages. So what we do is we invented the pot. And this is a little pot. It's the sort of pot that you'd have used in the late Neolithic period, the Stone Age. And so there's your cupped hands, if you like. And this little cup makes into a little cup that's easier to drink from. Because they didn't have tables in those days, it's round at the bottom so you can stand it, you know, in a little mark in the clay of your floor in your house. So that's Neolithic or Stone Age. These ones are from the very late Neolithic and Bronze Age. And this one here, you can see, is what they call a beaker. This is what the beaker people used. And so this one's marked with a comb, probably a horn comb or a bronze comb. And so this is one that I've made to show you what they were in the Bronze Age. These are reproductions I've made, but this is a real Iron Age one. This is over 2,000 years old. So it's done well, hasn't it? I got it on a market stall for 10p because the chap didn't know whose
good
it was.
Heavens.
Cheers.
Amazing, isn't it?
Lovely. These are cups made of horn. This is a horn cup, which is just a cow's horn, moo. And these are cups. This is your little cup, you see, because you're little. And that one comes from about there. And because I'm a bit bigger, my cup comes from up here somewhere. Do you see what I mean? So these are horn cups with a piece of horn in the bottom. They work. They're lovely cups to use. Of course, they don't cost anything. This cup's made out of leather. So you've got the cow's horn there and you've got the cow's hide there. This one's 300 years old. And so it's done quite well, really. Then we come on to pewter ones. We've got pewter cups here. These are medieval cups, the sort of cups that you used in the past. This is before the Reformation. This is a pewter spoon. And you can see little St. Peter there with the keys of heaven in his hand. After the Reformation, you'll learn about that in school. They took the saints off the top and sometimes they were remodeled. This one's got an acorn, an oak nut, you see. This plate's made of pewter. This cup's got a lid on it. But there was never much glass. Glass came in the 16th and 17th century. And so this is what we call a reamer. And this is the sort of cup that you'd have used then. Later on, we got porcelain that you'll... Oh, look, one of the little glass bottles that the borrowers use in our house.
Oh,
cheers!
The pixies have been here.
So this is our dresser. There's some pewter on the top here. And this is the sort of porcelain that we use nowadays. Have fun with history. Oh, by the way, just before you go, do you remember I asked you a question? Oh, some horn spoons there as well. What the little dip in the corner of the trencher was, can you see it there? It's for your salt. Some salt to sprinkle on your food. I love you more than I love salt in my food, Father. King Lear, William Shakespeare. He was born on St. George's Day.
What?
Have fun with history.